This video is an invitation to paint and everyone can participate. The subject this time will be the art of Sonia and Robert Delaunay. Here's an example of their artwork. Later on in this video I will also show you a number of late submissions for my previous invitation to paint. I'll explain it all in a second, just after this. Hi there, my name is Albert van der Zwart. Welcome to Imperfect Paintings, where it's all about improving your painting skills by looking at art yourself and the world around you. Due to the current pandemic, my local painting course had to be cancelled. I really miss seeing the participants. So I offer them a number of free online lessons, and this is one of them. And of course, are you, my YouTube friend, invited as well. In case you're new to my channel, whatever level your painting skills are at, just hop on board and have fun. To help you a bit, I take this not too complicated painting by Robert Delaunay. I'll show you others in a second. When I do like this, you'll perhaps see that in fact the whole painting is one big concentric circle. Circles in circles. The circles even seem to continue beyond the painting. Now I put the four cutouts back in. And there are also circles, and each quadrant was painted in a different color. Actually, they are more egg-shaped. This one may look way more complex and perhaps perfect like print work, but the design is basically a big circle with a number of smaller ones in the middle. Once I understand their design, they tend to look less intimidating and I start wanting to make my own. The last thing I want to point at is line. For instance in this one, going from bottom left to top right. It cuts the circles in half. And in the center, you see a half white circle and a half black one. In the ring around them, the colors just switch. Over to your design. You can start with a line and add circles. I use a marker only to illustrate. I do guess they just used things like a pencil, a ruler and a compass, or a diversity of different sized round items to create their design. Or do it the other way around. Visible lines are never used. Just look at this one again. The lines manifest themselves because another color is used for the next part. Here are a few more artworks made by Robert and Sonia Delaunay. Google the names and look at more paintings. Try to figure out the design in each one and decide what you would like to do. Oh. And to lower the bar a bit, I go back to this one. Zooming in here and here, you see he painted over an existing color and he didn't even do it carefully. And finally, this vertical line is straight, but the horizontal one gets lost somewhere on the left side. So be easy on yourself when painting. Anyone can paint like this, I guess. Still, they were the first to enjoy painting like this and will therefore be remembered. Sonia Delaunay was also a fashion designer, making sketches like these. Feel free to design your own pattern or wardrobe, quilt, or play around with watercolors. Or choose to paint like the ones I showed you earlier. Do keep in mind, you can borrow ideas or details from them, but please don't copy one of their artworks. I'm confident you are all capable of making your own design. Just play around and paint in their style. Feel free to use any material. Acrylics, oils, color pastels, crayons, or whatever works best for you. Please send in your submission, or more in case you get hooked, before October the 26th, 2020. You can find my email address and other details in the description below the video. I will show your submitted artwork in my new video in about 6 weeks. I will then also show how I paint like Robert and Sonia Delaunay and give you also some background information. In the video, I would like to put your first name and the country you live in next to your painting. Put them also in the email. I can't see what's going on in your mind when you're painting. Please share a line or two in the email what you experienced. Over to my previous invitation to paint. Look for geometric shapes in your neighborhood. Take pictures and make a painting inspired by what you saw. For those of you who missed it, up here you can find a link to both the invitation and the video in which I show the shapes I found and the paintings I made, and share all the received submissions. Here are some more beautiful ones I unfortunately received after I published the video. Enjoy! Franca started with texture printing, but worked in various ways, like used a red rag, made cutouts, or did collage. She often works process-based, where she lets the piece suggest the next move. Maris, or Maris, was making a texture painting and messed up. But in the mess, she found circles, triangles and squares, and chose to bring them forward. She even framed it. Jean found himself finger painting, combined with brushwork. Halfway, he associated painted shapes with trees and emphasized them. Old glitter paint was used for the sky. He enjoyed playing around. Ray used a variety of techniques, like gel printing. And for this one, he used acrylics. And finally, he jumped over to welding, creating this one. I hope you like these submissions just as much as I did. Oh, in the coming week or two, I will work on my website and skip one or two videos. Over to the new challenge. In case you accept this new painting invitation and create your own Sonia or Robert Delaunay artwork, please remember to email your submission before October 26, 2020. I'm already looking forward to receiving them. I wish you all the best, stay safe and happy painting! Because I can't see what's going round in your head while painting, please share a line or two in the email what you experienced.